Okay, so hopefully you've all seen Russell's paradox. Maybe you've since forgotten about it, thinking that modern mathematics knows how to deal with this and other paradoxes. Well, it has to do something in order to skirt this paradox, and it's basically the task of axiomatic set theory to find a way of dealing with a set as a primitive in such a way that this paradox no longer appears. So, axiomatic set theory. It, so to speak, voids Russell's paradox. By limiting the class of sets. All right, but you can't really do that in an effective way. All you can do is write down axioms for sets, and then attempt to show that the axiom system is consistent. All right, so for example, you have Zermelo's axioms. Let me remind you, what's the most important of Zermelo's axiom, because I'm going to need that in a second. It's the axiom of comprehension. So it says, given a proposition, I'll just write it as P of X. For any set A, the collection of elements of A such that the proposition holds is also a set. All right, so mathematicians use this every day, but you have to realize that this is a substitute for the idea, the naive idea of a set, which would say that any proposition defines a set. Can't allow any proposition to define a set, because in particular, X, not an element of X, is a proposition, and it leads to a paradoxical collection, which cannot be regarded as a set. So you need to have some control on your proposition to know that you get a set. In other words, if you simply write this formula, this collection may not be in the class of sets. However, if I limit myself to a preconceived domain Y, and then look at the elements of preconceived domain A, and then look at the elements of A that satisfy the proposition, then that is going to be a set. So literally, you can think about propositions as cutting out regions inside of larger sets. All
All right.
So
but at some point, you have to say what you mean by a proposition.
Okay, so that's where set theory becomes more technical. For that, I have to recommend really rigorous treatments of set theory where you develop a notion of mathematical logic, notion of symbols, languages, and you have to build up a vocabulary which allows you to eventually write down all possible propositions in set theory. And that's something that you can find in any standard advanced text on set theory. So you're absolutely right. That's part of the difficulty of making Zermelo's ideas work, is to have modern mathematical logic at your disposal. So I'm not going to try to discuss that now, but I can discuss it in terms of examples. So in my abstract, I refer to a special case. And this is where P of X is the proposition that appears in Russell's paradox. And so now, by what I've said, if A is itself a set, so that's a condition now. Not all collections are sets. I'm saying if A is itself a set, then the collection of elements of A, such that X is not an element of itself, is a subset of A. So this is guaranteed in the axiomatic theory. And at first it just looks like a curiosity. And what I've noticed in the textbooks is that the following elementary remark is made about this construction, and then the book moves on to other topics. Okay, so this is, it's practically an exercise. Let's call this subset RA. And then the exercise is that RA is not an element of A. This is where you see the important difference between two symbols in set theory. And so I emphasize that RA is a subset of A, but it's not an element of A. How do you prove this?